There are many tables in this world. Many tables in this world that those living on the margins have not been able to sit and feast. There are tables that are exclusive, only for the wealthy, only for those who fit a certain identity. But Christ invites all people to this table, all who love God, all who seek to live together in peace with God and with each other. All who hunger and thirst are welcome at this table. It is a table that is open to all and closed to none. There are no requirements of creed or denomination, affiliation or age, race, gender identity, sexual orientation, or citizenship. Simply come. Come and bring all the faith that you have to this table of grace. Let us pray together. Holy and loving God, we offer thanks for this day. Thanks for this table that is prepared before us. We offer gratitude for the virtual community that surrounds this table. It is in the seemingly mundane happenings, the sipping of our morning coffee, the buttering of toast, that we encounter your divine presence ever so delicately. We offer prayers for those without tables to gather around, prayers for those without food to eat, without beverage to quench their thirst. We are humbled by this reality as we prepare to receive this gift of grace.
The purpose.
night that Jesus was betrayed and arrested, he took the bread, he blessed it, and he broke it. And he said, "Take, eat. This is my body, the bread of life, given for you." Though we may be in many places right now, we are one body. One body at this table. So join us as we partake in remembrance of him. In that same way, Jesus took the wine and he poured it in a cup. He said, "This is something that you do every day. You drink. So drink this. Let it flow into your body and quench your thirst. And remember. Remember what we've done, the love that we have shared, the things that we have learned, and the work that is yet to be done. Eat, drink, remember. Remember that you are always welcome. Welcome to this table of God."
Come on.